So the title of my film, it's about Tonin Gini, who swam across the Adriatic Sea from Albania to Yugoslavia. So he wanted to be free from the oppressive regime of Enver Hoxha back in communism. And so he wanted to be free, and he swam freestyle. So the title is Freestyle to Montenegro, because he wanted to be free and he went to Montenegro. And that's the title, actually, of the film. I was making a short film last year, which world premiered in Dokufest. And during shooting, the actor told me that, oh, I know this story about this man who escaped Albania in 1987, like swam 18 kilometers, which is a great feat. And I told him I want to meet this person so I can talk more with him and maybe turn it into a documentary. So I met him, and as we talked for 3 hours, I actually immediately knew that he would be a great subject for a documentary. And I approached him, and he was completely fine with filming it. And 2 months after, which Dokufest last year was in August, and in September I started shooting the documentary. I didn't have time, I didn't have the budget to hire people, and in this profession you either hire people to pay them or you just do it yourself. So I started shooting myself, and it was very difficult at first because I was afraid that, can I make it myself? That was my fear constantly, because will I have lost sound or will something not work? So, and something difficult was that as I was filming, I had to concentrate on them so they could look at me, so the eye line could be looking at me, not at the camera. And so I sort of didn't look at the viewfinder or the camera. I just knew like the projection line of the lens. So I just kept looking at the subject and just filming it simultaneously. And it turned out to be fine. I was afraid that it would be like, camera would be like this or like that, but nowadays we can rotate footage, and it was actually a relief in post-production. And it worked out. It was very challenging, but it worked out very well, because now we have like sound equipment that can record fairly well, and it's doable to make a film yourself. You just have to know what you're doing, basically, so it works out.